Next is the if-then-else-if condition. When we have to combine several conditions, the else-if statement is helpful. We can use as many else-if statements that we need, and this allows to create as complicated branches as required. Now, let us look at an example. Suppose we have an input. We'll check for a condition. If the condition is true, then it will execute the first statement. Else if, specify the second condition, then execute the second statement. Else, the alternative statements will be executed. It will be ended by a end keyword. Okay. Let us practice an example. I equals 3, semicolon. If I equals equals 1, then display good morning. Else, if I equals equals 2, then display good afternoon. Else, display good evening. So you can see it has displayed good evening. I'm ending this loop with an end. So now, if this is clear, we'll move ahead with an application. Over here, we'll input our radius. Again, we'll calculate the area of a circle. Now, if the area is less than 10, it will display the statement number 1. Else if area is equal to 10, display statement 2. Else, display statement 3. Let us make this application. R equals 10. A equals pi into R square. If A is less than 10, then display area less than 10. Else if A equals equals 10, then display area equal to 10. Else display area greater than 10. So you can see it has displayed area greater than 10. Now if we want to find the value of A, we'll write disp A. So the value of A is 314.15927. Okay, if you know this, then we can proceed to our quick assignment about if then else if. You have to pause the video again, open Scilab, your console or environment. You have to input width and height to calculate the area of a rectangle. After calculating the area, print whether the area is greater than 10 or equal to 10 or if it is less than 10. So over here there are three conditions. The first one is greater than 10. The second one will check whether it is equal to 10. And the last one will check if it is less than 100.